नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू? ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल एंड फाइन आई होप। सो दैट वी आर गोइंग थ्रू आवर रिवीजन सेशन। चिल्ड्रन, दिस टाइम वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज माय बॉडी। इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स ऑफ आवर बॉडी। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्न दैट what are external organs and what are internal organs. Children, all parts that can be seen from outside, means those organs that can be seen from outside is called external organs. Opposite to it, those parts of the body which cannot be seen from outside, that are called internal organs. Let me tell you some example of external organs and internal organs. Children, our five sense organs like nose, eyes, ears are visible from outside. We can see it, so that are called external organs. But some organs work inside the body, like heart, like food pipe, like stomach, like small and large intestine. So these works inside the body, and these organs are called the internal organs. So our body is a very complex system, and it works like a machine with the help of different kind of organs presented in it. So the organs forms different systems also. One of such system is called the digestive system, about which we are going to learn. Have a look on the picture given in your book. So these are the organs which can participate in the digestion, or you can say digestive system of human being. So let's start from the very beginning. It is mouth, it is food pipe, then comes the stomach, the liver, the pancreas, the large intestine, the small intestine, then comes the rectum, and lastly anus. Children, first of all, line by line, means organ wise, we will learn. First of all, we will learn about the mouth. So in the mouth we are having two parts, that is teeth and tongue also. Today we are going thoroughly about the teeth. Teeth are very important part of our mouth, and it help to bite and chew the food. Not only this, it also provides a shape to our face and helps us to speak clearly. So these are the importance of our teeth. And now let's know about the two sets of teeth. Children, we will learn two things about teeth. First of all, we will learn about the two sets. These sets are milk teeth, means temporary teeth, and permanent teeth. On the other hand, we will learn about the types of teeth, that is other thing. First of all, let me explain you about milk teeth or temporary teeth. A baby is born with no teeth. All of you well know that when we born, we are having no teeth in our mouth. But when the baby is growing about 6 months old, then his or her teeth begin to appear in the mouth. By the time the baby is 3 years old, he or she has a set of 20 teeth. But these teeth are temporary. Why they are temporary? Because they used to fall, or because they used to broke down after some time. So these are temporary, that's why they are called temporary teeth, as well as milk teeth also. Now between the age of 6 to 12, the milk teeth fall or broke down, and one by one, and the new teeth grows at their places. These new teeth are called permanent teeth, because again they are not going to fall, and again not a new set is going to be provided to you. Means the permanent teeth, means the permanent teeth which works for our whole lifetime. There are 32 permanent teeth in number in our mouth. Now here is the picture of the whole mouth is given, but this is opposite. द फर्स्ट पार्ट अपर पार्ट इज द लोअर पार्ट एंड द लोअर पार्ट इज द अपर पार्ट आई थिंक. नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ टीथ. सो द फर्स्ट वन इज फ्लैट टीथ. द टीथ इन द फ्रंट ऑफ द माउथ दैट आर फ्लैट एंड आर यूज टू बाइटिंग एंड कटिंग ऑफ द फूड. Children, when we used to eat, many of the food items, we used to cut them first, then we used to eat them, to chew them and then to eat them. So these flat teeth are those teeth which can help us in cutting or biting the food items. Now there are four, they are known as incisors and there are four incisors in the upper jaw and the four incisors in the lower jaw also. Means 4 plus 4, we are having 8 incisors in our mouth. Then comes the pointed teeth. On the either side of flat teeth, means just behind, just beside flat teeth, is a sharp pointed tooth. They are used for tearing the food and they are known as canines. There are 4 canines in oval. Means 8 we have learned before, 8 flat teeth or 8 incisors are there in our mouth. And the second is how much? They are 4 in numbers. The canines are 4 in numbers. So 8 plus 4, both are 12 in number. Now we will learn the broad or grooved teeth, means molars and premolars. The teeth present at the back of our mouth. Children, if you will go to the mirror and open your mouth and you can see or you can find these molars and premolars, they are situated in the back side of our mouth and they play a most important role in chewing the food, because they used to chew the food properly. Without these teeth, we cannot chew the food properly. So the teeth present at the back of the mouth are broad and have grooves in them. They are used for chewing and grinding also, grinding the food also. They are known as premolars and molars. Let's know the number of these teeth. There are 8 premolars. Premolars comes before the molars. So they are total 8 in number. So 12 we have already learned about the canines and the incisors, and then again we are going to learn about premolars, and they are 8 in number, means total 20. Then comes the number of molars. The molars come after the premolars and there are 12 molars in all, 6 in the upper jaw and 6 in the lower jaw. It means total 32 teeth are permanent teeth. They are in number 32. There are 32 permanent teeth present in our mouth. Now comes the most important thing, that is the care of teeth. Children, our teeth is very important, and in the digestive system it plays a vital role. So if we are not going to take care of our teeth, we are going to be unhealthy. So that our teeth must be cared. Now the point comes, how can we keep our teeth safe? Our teeth are very important to us. We must take care of them. If we do not take care of our teeth, they can decay and fall. Ways to protect teeth. Children, all of us again and again ask you to brush your teeth twice a day. Means in the morning you must brush your teeth, and before going to the bed you must brush your teeth. Now the second is rinse or wash your mouth after every meal. You must rinse. You must keep some water in your mouth and you must rinse your mouth after taking any breakfast or lunch or dinner. After that, you must rinse your mouth. Then comes the third point. Avoid eating sweets or sugary snacks. Many of the children as well as the elders also, they like to eat cakes and pastries, sweet items. They also like to eat chocolates and toffees, candies. So all these are sugary and they affect our teeth very bad. Not only these things, but soft drinks are also very dangerous for our teeth. So if you want to keep your teeth safe, you must avoid sugary snacks as well as cold soft drinks. Now the next point is to visit a dentist for regular dental checkups. So children, what is dentist? Dentist is the doctor who treats our teeth. Dentist takes our dental care. So we must visit for regular dental checkups also. So people used to avoid this. People do not take care of their tooth and they wait for a long time to visit a doctor of dentist or dentist. But we must go to the dentist for a regular checkups. Then comes the next point, that is eat fruits like apple and guava and vegetables like radish and carrot. One thing to keep in our mind that both fruits, apple and guava, and here vegetables also, these vegetables are like radish and carrot. These are eaten raw. So such kind of fruits and vegetables provide strength to our teeth, and that's why they also provide exercise to our gums also, and we must eat such kind of fruits and vegetables. Then clean the tongue to remove the germs. So children, many of you are in habit not to clean the tongue. They used to brush their teeth, but they never used to clean their tongue with the tongue cleaner. So that is bad habit, because germs are there on the tongue and they used to damage your teeth also. So you must clean your tongue at the time of brushing your teeth. Last point is eat calcium rich food. Calcium, what is calcium? Calcium is that factor which provides strength to our bones as well as teeth. So eat calcium rich food. Then what is calcium found in? This calcium is found in eggs, milk and milk products also, for strong teeth. Not only teeth but bones also. So you must eat calcium rich food. Now very interesting thing given here in your book, the way of brushing. So if you go to your brush stand and you will watch the brushes kept in the stand, you can see that the brushes changed their shape, because it depends on the person who used that brush, and it depends on the person ki in which style does the person use the brush. Sometimes we find a brush in a flat way, sometimes it is twisted, sometimes it is very much used, and it changes its shapes. So such kind of thing shows that they are not used properly, because brushes often never change their shape. So what is the proper style to brush your teeth? Now it has been given in your book. First of all, have a look on the first picture. How to clean your flat teeth that is in front of your mouth? Brush up and down in front. You must brush up and down in the front. Then comes the inner part. Brush up and down in the back also, where grooved teeth and molars, premolars are found. Their upside and downside, both side you must brush up and down in the back also. Now comes how to brush our sides in the mouth. Always brush the teeth with a circular movement. Circular movement means like circle. You brush your teeth like you are moving a circle. So that movement provides exercise and as well as a neat and clean brushing to your mouth, to your teeth. So this is the proper style to brush your teeth, and you must take care to, at the time of brushing your teeth. Now comes, do you know children, if sugar and bacteria are left on the teeth for long, they can cause tooth decay. Decay means the strength of the teeth is lost and it is totally affected by the germs, and it is then used to fall and it decays. So that if you are going to take sugary item regularly and not brushing your teeth, then you will lose your teeth also. Then comes the second number, that is the white outer covering of teeth is called enamel. The white outer covering, that's why our teeth looks white. So it is the outer covering of the teeth and it is called enamel, and it is the hardest substance in the human body. So this is to remember in your mind, that the white outer covering of teeth is called enamel and this is the hardest substance in the human body. The next is the tongue. The tongue is a soft movable part inside our mouth and it is used for tasting, licking and speaking. It also pushes the food into the food pipe at the time of swallowing. So this is the tongue given here. About tongue we have learned also in our previous class. Have a look on the picture of tongue. There are the four tastes given here. First of all, let me explain you, do you know? The back of the tongue is sensitive to bitter taste. Its sides are sensitive to sour and salty taste. And the tip of the tongue picks up the sweet taste. So look it. Along with the teeth and tongue, there are three pairs of salivary glands present in the mouth. And these glands secrete saliva. So digestion of food begins when we put the food in our mouth. So what did the teeth do? The teeth help in breaking the food into smaller pieces and chewing it. Here the saliva gets mixes with the food and make it soft. Saliva converts insoluble starch into soluble sugar. You must have noticed that when you chew chapati for a longer time, it starts tasting a little sweet. This is due to the action of saliva on our food. It is very important to chew the food properly for proper digestion of food. Have a look on the tongue. So this is your tongue and it is having here bitter taste in the back portion, then sour in the side, then salty here in the side, and then here at the tip of the tongue it is sweet. And this, there are three pair of salivary glands present in our mouth and these glands secrete saliva. So this saliva is very important because it converts insoluble starch into soluble sugar. So this is the thorough of teeth and tongue. In our next class, we will learn about other body organs which help in digestion.